is the universal response for all of the priests I talked to, except Doris? And that response was, I hope somebody else is preaching this Sunday. She knew she was safe. These are all mystical blessings. But I have to confess to you, and Doris, don't chime in here, but I am a little off center when it comes to some of these things. I found a very warm hymn from, particularly the reading from Isaiah, because it brought back memories of what was probably my favorite summer as a child. It was when I was 11 years old, going through the summer. Think back, if you can, I'm trying to remember those times. One of the things that was great about it, for instance, was that I had finally grown into my feet. And those of you who are awkward teenagers or awkward preteens know exactly what I mean. My coordination had finally caught up to my greatest desire. When I threw a baseball, it actually went where I needed it most of the time. On top of that, the sort of innate clumsiness that I had inherited from my mother seemed to disappear. And so I thought it was going to be one of those wonderful times, and it was. One of the things that I discovered that summer, we lived next to across the alley from a large bar. Believe it or not, in the city there was a bar. The barn was mostly abandoned, but it wasn't the barn that was interesting. That summer, a group of us discovered growing behind the barn wild grapes. As we were being inquisitive 11-year-olds, we first of all tasted them. I can testify to you, you don't want to eat wild grapes. They have a most unusual pungent effect on the human mind. But all wasn't lost. We also discovered that wild grapes make perfect missiles we hurled at one another. And there's a reason. Those of you who remember being 11, one of the problems with hurling missiles at one another was that nobody would ever tell the truth. I hit you. No, you didn't. You missed by a mile. No, yes, I did. No, you didn't. The reality was that when you threw bright wild grapes, they left a smell that was totally unmistakable. Now, as you know, 11-year-old boys aren't exactly good at debating, but this would actually make an 11-year-old go take a bath. They smell it so bad. I tell you that story because, interestingly enough, in the poetic section from Isaiah, which we read today, the center of this section was God's comment that I expected grace and you gave me wild grapes. Because that's not what it says. The Hebrew word that we translate as wild, guess what? It's properly translated as stinking. So God is saying, I expected sweet, wonderful grace, and you gave me stinky grapes. You can imagine this disappointment. This is not a love poem. No offense to the commentator who wrote that. It would be nice if you had actually read a book about it. That's what I'm saying. This is a lament. God is lamenting his own sense of loss. He has called these people together. He brought them out of the land of Egypt. He gave them the land of promise. He oversaw and protected them. In other words, they were his theme that he loved and he cared for. And he asked only one thing, that they produce a healthy crop. Sweet, edible bread. And what did they give him? Stinky grapes. Stinky fruits. It's easy to feel superior when think about that, but you know, when I begin to think about my own life, I'm kind of a stinky grape sometimes myself. I'm not the whole vineyard, but I don't always produce what God God as well. They had lots of moments where they were stinking grace. Read their history. They even call themselves a stiff-necked people. Stubborn, uncooperative, self-centered. Bring the sweetness of his love.